Welcome to Compute 175 Python review. Often you want to represent some output in a particular way so that it takes the right place and space on your screen. For example, when you output a table. So you want to format your results, whether strings or numbers, in some specific way. For instance, when you want a certain number of digits after a decimal point, or that a string doesn't take more than a certain width. This is what we call string formatting, and we will discuss this in this video. Suppose I have two string variables, field with compute and number for 175, and I'd like to print them together in one line. I could say print field plus. The plus is a concatenation of strings, so it'll concatenate both and then print them. That's exactly what I told the computer to do. But what if I didn't want them to be concatenated that way? I wanted a space in between. Well, I could say print field, comma, number. And the comma adds a default separator, which is space. I still have them in one line. But what if I didn't want the space? I wanted a different kind of separator, for example, a dash. The default one is space. How can I change that default one? Well, I could say print field, comma again, number, but I'll add another comma and I say the separator, I want it to be something else. I say sep is equal to a dash. And now what I get is a dash in between the two. Python also allows you to have two commands in the same line, separated by a semicolon. So you could say print the field, semicolon, and then immediately after, print the number. But what will happen is that they're printed in two separate lines. That's not exactly what you want. So like we were able to redefine the default separator, we can also redefine the default ending of the print. So print always finishes by printing a carriage return, so a new line basically. And we can tell it to change that. So we can say print the field and the ending of that, I want the end to be something else, so I redefine it. For example, let's say it's a space and a pound. And then immediately after, I will print the number. And that's exactly what I get. So I can redefine the separator, but I can also redefine the ending of the print command. So suppose you want to arrange a string to contain the content of some variables in some given format. Here we have four variables: field, num, student name, and mark. One is a string, and then there's a number, then a string, and then a float. And let's suppose I want to create a string. So s equals, and I will create the string that says so-and-so received this mark in this course. So what I can do, I can use what we call placeholders in this string. And the first thing I want to do is a string. I want to print a string within this string. I will have a string in the string. So I say, put the placeholder, starts with percentage and s for string. I want a string there and say received, and then I have to put the mark. Oh, I want to put a placeholder for the mark, and the mark is a float, so I can say percent f for float. But more than that, I want to say, I don't want all these digits after the decimal point. I want just two digits, and I want it taking five positions maximum. So I say 5.2 means five positions, two after the decimal point, and it's a float. Received this mark in, and then I put the course. The course is again a string, so I have percentage, the string which is for the field, followed by a dash, for example, and the number of the course, and that's a decimal point, that's a number, so I'll put percentage D. Okay, I close my string. But these are placeholders. Where will I get the numbers, these strings? So I will say take them from this tuple, and the tuple has, so the first one is the student ID, student number, student name. The second one is the mark, followed by the field, compute, and then followed by the number of the course. Now if I check, what is in S? Give me S. Eddie received 91.67, so it's around it, in compute 175. Now instead of creating a string with this string formatting, I could print directly this string formatting. I could say print the same expression, and it'll print it directly. Now, what kind of placeholders can I have? There are different kinds of placeholders, and here's a table showing the different ones for integers, unsigned integers, floating points, single characters, strings, and we'll see a little bit more complicated ones. The syntax of string formatting is as follows. You have a string which has placeholders. Each placeholder is suffixed or prefixed, sorry, by a percentage sign. And then you fill it from variables or values from a tuple. And between the tuple and the string, you put a percentage sign. Like we saw how we formatted the student mark by specifying two digits after the decimal point, well, the placeholders can be a little bit more complicated and can have what we call modifiers. And the modifiers can define, for example, the width, can define how many you have after the decimal point, but can also define whether it's left justified, right justified, whether you want to pre-fill it with leading zeros, and things like that. For example, if I want to print the field compute on 10 positions, I could do this way. So I'm putting between brackets so we can count the 10 spaces. And indeed, I get compute, and it's actually right justified. If I want to do it left justified, I just have to add the minus sign here. And you can see it's left justified. The same with numbers. So if I want to print mark, which is a float with two digits at the end, but I wanted leading zeros in front, I could do it this way. That's what you get. The percent character has a meaning in string formatting. We use it within the string as a prefix to placeholders. What if I need to have the percent sign as part of the string? I want to print it. I'll leave you with this exercise to investigate. String formatting can also be done with a function called format, which can do everything we talked about and beyond. I'll let you investigate this function. We discussed how we can create strings in specific format, how we can print data using placeholders and modifiers.